Hello and welcome to the show. I'm here today going to be taking a look at some of the new stuff added to the crew from the new Wild Run update. And the first thing you will immediately notice is the game. See, I'm currently in reverse. The game does look a hell of a lot prettier. The graphics have had a big update. It was never a particularly ugly game to start with. But, it certainly does look really rather nice, especially the cars. The cars seem to look a lot more detailed and so on. There are new weather effects. I thought it was going to rain. It's kind of got all miserable and cloudy. The new weather effects are really, really rather cool. I will show them off as and when we come to them. And, of course, there are some new vehicles and some new specs. Today, you're going to be taking a look at the monster trucks, because you can make a very, very silly one. Right, we are going to change our vehicle somewhere in here. We are going to get an all-stock vehicle. I don't know where on earth it is. Somewhere in amongst all of this lot, I've got, here it is, the Fiat 500 Abarth. Yes, this can be turned into a monster truck. Sadly, this is the only kind of really ridiculous vehicle that can be made into a monster truck. I was kind of hoping for perhaps a few more slightly silly vehicles able to turn into a monster truck. But I'm glad there's at least one that is capable of being made really rather silly. I've just sort of started playing this, so I have one free kind of kit, and I'm going to use it on a monster truck. So let us take the little Fiat. I have no idea how this is going to drive. There's been quite a big update to the driving physics on this game. I have no idea how on earth a monster Fiat is going to drive. We're going to give it 639 horsepower, 700 near enough foot-pounds of torque. It's going to be a little bit heavier, to say the least. Yes, let us turn the little Fiat into an absolutely ridiculous vehicle. It's like the monster panto. It is absolutely glorious. Yay! We've still got to go through, find the missions to get the little mini games, almost, to get the parts for the car to upgrade it performance wise. Let's have a look, shall we? I don't know what front bumpers we can have on a monster Fiat 500. I think we need a diffuser. I think we definitely need an extra large diffuser. Are these just different sort of headlights? I don't really like this one. Is going to have to do. Yes, we need diffuser and the side bits. Is it canards or however on earth it's pronounced? Yes, we need them. Or a splitter. Sorry, not diffuser. Diffuser is on the back. And we can have equally impressive. There we go. Yeah, that's the one that we want on. On the back of our Fiat. I am liking this. Now I think we'll stick with the standard one. Please let me have, please let me have a really silly rear wing. Come on. I'm hoping for that's not, they're pretty decently stupid, I would say. Yeah, I mean, that's kind of like a lunch table on the on the back of our Fiat. Ah, yes, we need all of the vents for reasons. Yes, we shall have them. There we go. I have a monster Fiat 500. It's fantastic. Performance, I was going to say, I didn't think we could buy anything from... I don't know why the performance shop kind of... It's not really a particularly useful thing. Bugger it. It is what I feared. Okay, yeah, all of the kits are as ludicrously expensive as they were in the beta. That's a slight pain in the arse. So, our monster Fiat is ready to go and tackle some events. Now, I quite like the way that they have done the whole Wild Run and the summit system. It's interesting. It's certainly different for a racing game. Right, we will go here. So, we've got in the Bonneville Salt Flats, every month they have, I guess it's like a week-long event or whatever, but before you can kind of take part in the main event, there's all of these qualifying events. Now, these take place over a couple of days, I believe. We've got Summit Qualifier going on here at Mount Rushmore, and these cover a variety of different things. So if we just go and enter over here, I think you have to come in the top so many percents to get a medal, and you need 3 medals to make it to the main event, if I have read everything, if I've inferred everything correctly. So I'm just about in the bronze medal positions at the moment. I haven't completed all the events yet. So as you can see, they had from the 12th to the 19th there was a qualifier, from the 19th to the 22nd there's a qualifier, and this is all actual
real life day times, if you like, or dates. So it's over a course of a period of time. And these have all sorts of different little events to go through. So there's PvP races, there's a crew race, a drag time trial, drift trials, normal time attack. You need a certain vehicle. I'm not quite sure if I like that particularly, because that means that gets very expensive. And then there's all of these little different stunts and challenges to do. We're going to have a look at the Monster Arena. I don't know where we're going. I'm assuming we're going to a Monster Arena that I haven't been to yet, because in the beta we only played at the Bonneville Assault Flats, I believe. So I'm kind of curious to see what these other arenas will be. I'm hoping we're going to be going to another arena. The way that these work, does this look different? Or am I just, this is very much different. Okay, so the way that these arenas work is you have got to find these little pickups around the place. They will give you points, 500 points for that one. There's some 1,000 point ones lying around as well. You want to get as many points as possible within the time limit. You can also do things like backflips will award you bonus points. Am I going to have enough speed to get all of them? No, not quite. I couldn't quite reach it. Probably be a good idea to upgrade my monster truck a little bit, but there we go. Come on, backflip. Hey, there we go. I wonder if I can do a double backflip with the monster Fiat. This is looking like a mighty loop the loop that I'm not going to be able to get up. This is a really quite cool arena. And the way that this kind of works, because of the time limit, this is all about finding the best possible route. If you want to go for really high scores, it's all about finding the best possible route through here within the 2-3 minutes time to score as many points as possible. So the hard to reach power ups will be the most. So 1,000, I've got 2,000 points for doing that loop the loop. But you've got to, it's kind of like a time versus reward kind of thing. If they might be hard to reach, but if you spend sort of a minute trying to get 1,000 points, you'd be better off, you know, perhaps going for a large cluster of lower point ones and so on. And I kind of like that as a challenge, because you've got to think slightly differently. And of course, you've got ridiculous vehicles. I'm doing loop the loops with a monster Fiat 500. I like it when games let me do this. This is good news. Oh, I missed that one completely. That was terrible driving. From me, the monster trucks, occasionally the wheels get a little bit glitchy with going through the floor. I have seen that. When I first fired this game up, you do like a little practice run. Oop, double backflip. Woohoo! When I first fired this game up, did a practice run and instantly got a wheel stuck on the monster truck I was driving. I think it was a Ford Raptor one. Instantly got the wheel stuck in the floor. So it is something to be aware of. They can sometimes get a little bit unhappy. I want to go in the middle. I want to see what's in the middle of this area. They look like lots of points. How do I get into the middle? Can we find a way in somewhere? Is there a way in? Do I have to climb up somewhere? Ah, found a way in. Aha. Alright, okay, so it's kind of like a big bowl thing. Let's see if we can pick some speed up around here and get... I don't know how on earth I missed that first one. Let's go for boost around here. Now, I'm guessing there is going to be... Oh, it's fine. Oh, I missed the important one. I have done terribly. Now, I'm going to hazard a guess. There might be points going up here. No, there's... Okay, there's no... I was expecting there to be kind of points towards the top. Oh, dear. We've had a small incident and I've missed everything. Okay, not been a particularly fantastic first opening a run, or go for a double backflip. Hey! Double backflip, probably the best way for scoring points in the time. Oh, we've got... we're about to run out of time. Okay, this is quite an interesting arena that we have got here. Yeah, we missed it. We ran out of time. Bugger. Okay, yeah, that's an interesting arena. These things will generate a part of some sort. Would we to level 31 part? Sure, okay, I'll take it. It's better than what I have now. The other events I was doing were giving me the top tier, was it platinum or something, parts? I can't remember. Then that was actually quite useful for modifying some of my vehicles. So you get the idea of the monster arenas. I might actually have... Shall we have another go? We'll have another go at this monster arena. That was quite... I was quite poor. In all honesty, I spent too long faffing around. Yeah, it's going to be a case of, you know, you run these a few times just to sort of learn where the big power-ups are, where you're going to need a big sort of run-up to hit a jump hard enough to get to the 5,000 point ones. I mean, 5,000 points is a massive thing in this particular sort of event. And you are going to want a modified truck if you can get all sort of platinum level 50 parts or whatever. I'm hoping I'm remembering that correctly, how the modified system works. It's been ages. I think it's platinum is the hardest ones, the rare ones to get. Yeah, if you get all of them parts, you'll have more speed, so you can get around the arena quicker, and so on. That'll be very, very useful. Oh, Christ. Okay, no, we're good. We're fine. I just got a little bit scared. The handling physics have been tweaked. It's actually, it's much better to drive. It's still not perfect, but it is better to drive. Oh, Christ. There's quite a fine line with hitting these. Uh-oh, we're going to have a roll. Oh, okay, no, we're just going to have a twitch. Less a roll, more just a mid-air twitch. Okay, I think was quite a good idea to go for these loops and just kind of go around them and gain some points. Yeah, the handling physics has been adjusted. Nitro can now actually be used. It doesn't just spin the wheels permanently. And I have tested this with a variety of vehicles, and it does work with your street cars and your performance circuit cars, all of them. I haven't found one yet that has unusable nitro, which is lovely. Previously nitro was pretty much just press button, get wheel spin. Apart from in the Hummer, which is why I had a racing Hummer. I don't know why I'm doing a wheelie there. Well, we've fallen off our little platform. Things were going so well. I'm actually even sure I'm not really doing better this run. I'm kind of just exploring different places and kind of it's sort of ish working. Right. I have a plan. The plan, we're going to go up here. We're going to do a backflip. Yeah, sure. We might as well, since we're pointing this direction, get some points, because there is, I believe, a 5,000 points in this arena is down here. So we kind of need to get here, go for the boost, hope we can get enough height. We have nowhere near got the speed to be doing that. We've smacked a wall slightly. I think my Fiat may need some parts, but it's okay. I'll have a go at getting some of them for this. I'm definitely not doing better. I don't remember what I got up to last time points-wise. Whoa! Oh, Christ, there's a platform there. Double backflip still. I mean, that was more of a roly-poly once we got on the platform, I will be honest. There was less of a backflip and more of sort of a flop from the Fiat. Where was the... Oh, Christ, we've kind of got that a little wedged. Where was the loops that I was doing last time? I found like a different chain of... they're the loops. There's like a chain of loops on the outside. There's a chain of loops on the inside. It'd probably be a good idea to try and get around both of them in one sitting. Oh, if you've got the speed and the monster truck capable. Oh, wrong gears. Boost! Come on, little Fiat, we can do this. We can get the 1,000. There we go, you are going quick enough. 10 seconds remaining. I'm not going to do it, I don't think. Come on! I'm going to run out of nitro. Boost, boost, boost. Hey, 17,000. I don't remember how many points I got last time out. I think it'll tell me if I've improved or not. That was a fairly poor run. You are probably better just sitting in front of a ramp and trying to do double backflips off it and kind of just repeating it again and again. That does seem to be a good way to get points in my experience. That's certainly what I did in the beta to get points. Okay, that was actually pretty good. These monster events, this monster truck event is great for getting the extreme points. So I said the kits were very expensive. Now, when you get, you can see there's two bars. There's an orange and a blue bar. The blue bar is an event ranking. I'm not quite sure why there's a bar. It could just tell me the position. The extreme points bar is the more interesting one. When you fill that up, you get a free kit. So I believe I'm getting a monster truck kit first for free. It will take a while to earn the points to get them, but you can grind out an event if you want. And getting sort of 60 for that is not too bad. Right, let us go and try some of these events. Let's have a go with an escape one. I'm hoping it'll keep me in the monster truck for this. So these are like the little kind of free mode events. You find these around all over the place. Camera's got a little bit unhappy with going down there. Sure, we're going to go. Probably wasn't a clever idea faffing about with the camera angles. So the escape mode, you basically just got to try and get away from a kind of invisible sort of boundary that will expand, and you've got to try and get as far away as possible in a limited amount of time. The further you get away, the more points you're going to get. We're actually going to be able to get a platinum medal without too much trouble with this monster truck, it seems. Oh, hey, I'm not bothering turning. We're going to go for a fly across the car park. I'm in a monster truck. I can. Probably was a better idea to turn. When I was doing this with a raid truck, I tested this out earlier, doing it with a raid truck, and we've unlocked a rear bumper part. Damn it. Could you not give me a engine part? I wanted to make the car much faster. that was a new record. That's actually not too bad. These monster trucks, good for this kind of thing, it turns out. And this all goes towards the ranking, of summit ranking, if you like. I think the reason why a monster truck is much better for this is it deals with the bumps so well, because, well, it's a monster truck. These actually drive pretty well on the roads. There's plenty of grip with these. Imagine what a strange sight this would be. You're just driving around, minding your own business, normal day. Normal day, and then you see this thing come around a corner and smack into the front of your Chevy. Go! Move out of the way! Bugger! I was really hoping there wasn't going to be a car there. Can we get some, now, engine brake parts? Maybe, I don't know, I was getting all platinum parts for this. Maybe because this is a lower tier vehicle? I don't know why. It's, I guess someone else must have beaten my previous best or whatever. Okay, let's actually try and get a clean run without sort of flying it at the car park, and then I think we might be good to get some more points. Right, so we want to. Yeah, this actually really, I'm really surprised how well this turns. It is so much better than my raid truck down that part of the the course. You could really brake very, very late, and really, I guess the four-wheel steer is helping it out down here for finding some of that grip. And then we're going to fire the nitro down here. Oh, we're actually going a really long way. I will take this. It's looking good. I'm pleased with that one. Woohoo! We have done it. And what do we got to get? Oh, we got a colour part. Oh, we're going to play in the water. Can we go deeper in the water? This is the important questions when it lets me get out of here. Hey, event ranking shot up. Thank you. I will take that one. Can we go and... Oopsie, that's the wrong button. I will remember the controls eventually for this game. There we go. Can we go and play in the water more? Now we have a monster truck. Here we go. Are we going to have a swimming Fiat? Oh, no, that's a very, very deep river. Yeah, we can't go play in the water. We can't go waterfording with monster trucks. Ooh, uh-oh. Oh, no. Oh, no. Fiat! No! Get out of there! It doesn't like... Okay, let's not play in the river. Ooh, no. Oh, dear. Okay, river dangerous. River is a bad place. Oi! Excuse me. River is definitely a bad place to be going to play. Hello, very brightly coloured Nissan Skyline. Right, what else was I going to show? I can't even remember. I got distracted playing with a monster truck. This is what happens in this game. Right, let's go and we'll try the other events. That's what we were going to do. Because I'm lazy, I'm just going to quickly go up. No. Oh, that's the thing we did want. Never mind. Enter. Yes, we want to go to the qualifier. I was going to look at the other challenges. Let's have a go with the hill climb one, sorry. As I reckon this monster truck is probably a good vehicle for this kind of thing. This one's a pain in the ass, if I remembered it correctly. There is a slight downside to these events. So the qualifiers all take, like, all of the events for this qualifier take place around the area, around Mount Rushmore, which is fine. The problem is that said events, though this bit here that we are now currently climbing up the hill for, yeah, this is the bit that was used for the other event. And because this is, well, online, you often find vehicles kind of competing going both ways and, well, bumping into one another. The monster Fiat has been scuppered. Oh, the monster Fiat's done an endo. Oopsie. We had a... but there was a small issue. Damn it. Yeah, often you can have vehicles sort of going... why have we got all the rear bumper parts going on for this? Oh, that was awful. It was going so well up until that point as well. Yeah, you can end up interfering with one another's runs. It can get a little frustrating. We seem to be doing okay at the moment. I tried it earlier and there's about four of us. Two of us were trying to go up the hill. Two of them were trying to go down the hill, and they constantly bumped into one another, so I gave up. Yeah, it can get a little frustrating. Although, if that's the case, just jump somewhere else and then re-teleport yourself back here, and often vents will have cleared out. This is a fantastic vehicle for doing this sort of thing. I will point that out. This is absolutely fantastic for the mountain climbing. Okay, monster truck. Oh, now we've got a bonnet part. I want the engine bits. It's kind of cool that it will now give you random... it'll give you kind of random stuff for completing these challenges. I like that it does that. It's just when I'm kind of hoping to get engine bits to, you know, start modifying a relatively basic vehicle is a little bit of a pain. Right, well, we are going to have to go around here to get... Oh, Christ, I hate that corner. That's why I was trying to avoid going around there. Oh, we've done a backflip. We don't get bonus points for that. Hey, Fiat, can we do a wheel? We can do a wheel. Oopsie. Well, it's a fail race video. You know stuff is going to end upside down in a fail race video. Let's try again, shall we? Right, we could, and what probably would be a sensible idea is you can, of course, back up and go through that sort of start gate with more speed. That would probably be sensible. Right, so we really want to make sure we get this slowed down to get turned around there. Now, nitro fire up the hill. There we go. That's the ticket. I was kind of hoping we'd get away without having to go for all of these. The monster truck is going to bounce. Oh, we're still going to have the time to... No, we're not going to be able to do it. We need more speed. We need more points for getting out there. I like how I beat the platinum time as well, and it still didn't give me the... Oh, now I've got another colour part. Okay. I was testing this earlier with my Raid Dodge Ram, and I was getting all the engine bits. So, sure, I don't quite know what that is. Right, what we're going to do is, because I am slightly, well, I say slightly struggling, I'm just that little bit away from platinum. We're going to go over here. Oh, stick on the brakes. Because now we're just going to have that little bit more speed as we cross the start line. So, you know, it'll save us a little bit of time. All right, fire all of the nitro. Should put us well ahead of the platinum ghost. And then we'll get more points, I believe, for hitting these if we hit them quicker. Right, this one here is a little bit of a fiddle. And for a monster truck, it's, monster truck a little bit wide for getting through that part. I'm not sure we're really doing any better. No, we're not particularly. Oh, go on. I can't. I was closer that time around. I'll probably have to go get some engine bits for this and make it a bit quicker. And we've got another front bumper part. Okay, it seems it wants to give me all the cosmetic stuff. Were we going to look at anything? I can't even remember what else I was planning on doing with this. It's a lot of fun. The Fiat. Shall we go have a look at these? Free drive stunts. This is an interesting little idea. I do quite like it. I know how to do this. I did it earlier. I find it peculiar that it's decided to tell me that now. This is an interesting little idea. It'll basically just give you random stuff to be doing. So let's say you want to drive the length of the map or something. Apparently driving is a pretty simple task. Normally they're more difficult than this. I also like how it's giving me distance despite being miles off-road and nowhere near the right side of a road anywhere. This, you can kind of just do these wherever. So if you're just wandering around, you want to drive, you know, long distances, you can do this to kind of kill the time and keep things interesting. It'll give you various goals to do and to achieve within a set time limit. Most of the ones I've come across have involved sort of near misses or travel at a certain amount of speed for so long. So let's say like 160 miles an hour for... 14, 16 seconds. Am I going the wrong way down? Is this a one-way road? I'm very confused. Apparently I can't be doing this. I can't drive 2 miles off-road. It wants me to drive on the right side of the road for 2 miles, but... Oh, never mind. We'll have to go up here and then... Oh, crap. We're going to go under the motorway. I should not have faffed about off-road. You kind of get the idea. These will give you... sort of challenges that you can do just as you're driving around, and it's kind of a distraction almost for when you're doing the long road trips. It gives you something to do on long journeys. It can be done in whatever sort of vehicle you want. Of course, a lot of the speed related ones will be easier if you do it in a circuit car. See, forgetting to change up gear. Apparently we can't do this here. I forgot. You can teleport around while you're in these challenges. So let's say there's one that you've got to keep a speed up above 180. Well, you know, you're going to want to go on a motorway, aren't you? So you can just teleport your car. The time will keep going down. It's just more stuff to do, and I like that. I like that there is more stuff to do. I'm slightly disappointed we haven't seen any rain, because the rain is pretty cool on here. And we can cover a couple of miles in our monster fear. Everybody's having a normal day, and then there's me going down here. And these kind of challenges, they're broken up into sort of two parts. So you'll have, you know, a drive a certain distance, or drive, or I've seen drift ones or whatever it is, and then you'll have another one of a different sort, perhaps get so many near misses within 4 minutes. Hello, officer. I'm honestly not doing 150 miles an hour in a monster truck. Totally not doing. Why is there a giant cow? Since when is there be a giant cow in the crew? I am confused. When did that get there? Well, I'm still discovering stuff. Let's face it, not exactly surprising considering the size of the map here. There is a giant cow. So there we go, we completed one of the stunts. What are we going to have me do next? I might want to go down that slip road. Near miss 20 cars. Ooh, okay. We've got to do 20 cars without crashing. Have I got to do 20 cars in a row without crashing? Or have I got to do... I don't know, actually. Okay, well, motorway is still a good place to do this. Oh, apparently that counted as a near miss. I did bounce off it. Meh, I'll take it. There are some that will say sort of you're not allowed to crash. I assume that is going to reset it if I do have an accident, I think that's what it does with the speed ones. I haven't actually crashed in a no crash one, so I don't know. And I don't intend on finding out at this particular moment in time unless I do it accidentally. Oh, okay, like that. If it resets it, no, it hasn't reset it. Maybe it just doesn't count it if I crash. I don't know. Maybe it only counts crashes as when, like, the proper wrecks. I'm not 100% sure on that, but you get the idea. Why is there cows in the middle of the road now, for God's sake? The farmers need to keep a better eye on their livestock going on there, because that is just wandering down the central reservation. Oh dear. You earn money, you earn rank points for the challenges, and you earn a little bit of the extreme points. I am going to herd cows. Get off the motorway, you morons. No, yeah, oh, right, we are professional cow herders with a monster truck. Go on, right, you lot are safe. Where is the rest of them? Oh, one more. Come on. Off the road. Off the road. That is the most pathetic horn for a monster truck I've ever heard. Get off the road, you silly animals. Right, are the cows safe? It seems like they are, apart from that one there. Slightly kamikaze. Either way, we have cleared the cows from the motorway. See? The uses of a Fiat 500 monster truck for cow herding. And now we've got to drive into oncoming traffic at however much speed and kind of hold it here. This is a little bit too wide for this kind of challenge. Oh dear, we may have eaten a Ford. I will be honest, I think the monster truck is probably going to come off better. But, oopsie daisy. Yeah, I quite like these challenges. It's just, you know, as I said, more things to do. So if you want to go on those long road trips and you want to have events to be doing while doing said road trips, you can. And if we just go abort, I think we will. Nope, we're still doing the challenges. How do we stop challenges? I think if we go here, do we go? Yeah, there we go. You can abort them, and yeah. I know we failed that one there, but there was, yeah. You can go through there and get some summit ranks and so on. I like this update. It is a tad expensive, I will be honest. It adds some cool stuff. Like the visual stuff, I believe, is all free. If you want, like, the new specs and so on. I assume if you want the events as well, you will have to pay. I think it's about 25 quid, if I remember correctly. It is quite expensive for what it is, but it is a lot of fun. There are some bikes as well that I may test at a later date. Yeah, it's I think the main sort of question with this update was it sort of reinterest me in the crew? I lost interest in this game a while ago and hadn't played it for a while. And I think that's the biggest thing with this update, is it enough to bring people back into playing the game? And certainly, I think it is for a while. I'm not sure long-term wise. Money is still a little bit of a pain in the ass to get, and the kits are very, very expensive. I think they would have been better off either having events. I don't know how much money you're going to get for the main summit events, admittedly. That might solve things. There may be some big, big prizes in that, but you can see the kits are very, very expensive for the cars. I still fear that money is a little too awkward to earn here. Now you get to see the rain. Yeah, it certainly looks very pretty. We're just going to ruin someone's field. I think it's certainly enough to get me playing the crew a bit more. How long it will keep my attention, I don't know. I'll probably mess about with all of the new vehicles once I have the bloody money for it. Yeah, I like it. It is a shame it's a little bit expensive, but I would still give it a recommendation, because I think there's enough crazy stuff. There's certainly enough crazy stuff to keep me entertained for a while on here. Anyway, that is it for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, goodbye.